My name is Jakub Radzikowski, and I'm the culinary education designer.
Hi, I'm Luke, and I'm a senior teaching fellow at Imperial College London. Chemical Kitchen was born out of the observation that chemistry students could benefit from the same training that chefs get in the way they work safely and in a collegiate way towards creating new dishes.
In Chemical Kitchen, students from across the college engage in cooking activities that parallel their work or their studies, and that gives them a different perspective on their profession.
Today we're in the Chemical Kitchen, where students think scientifically about their approach to cooking.
As the holiday season approaches, roast dinners are back on the menu, which means the age-old debate is back.
What is the best way to cook a roast potato? We're here in Imperial's Chemical Kitchen to see if we can improve the humble roast potato using maths.
My name's Hannah, and I'm a PhD student looking at new ways to deliver vaccines into the body.
And my name's Sikaru, and I'm working on developing methods to make drug-like molecules.
And we help run demonstrations in the Chemical Kitchen for students.
A typical session in the Chemical Kitchen brings students together around a base recipe that we provide. The students then have to do the reading, bit of research, come up with a plan and execute their plan together, where they look at different conditions for cooking. And the idea is that they can compare results and show us their creations and which ones work best.
Every head chef, whether that's you, your housemate, or whoever's in charge of the kitchen, has their own way of making the roast potato.
But it is generally accepted that a good roast potato should be golden, have a crispy surface and a fluffy interior.
The classic recipe includes peeling, cutting into quarters, parboiling, and roasting to perfection in the oven.
I think mixing cooking with science is very interesting because you can do it on different levels. You can just use science to cook better, but you can also use cooking to teach science in a better way. The potato experiment reflects what we do in Chemical Kitchen because we want the students to actively think about what they're doing before they do it, plan and execute things to get the best result possible.
Roast potatoes become crispy via the Maillard reaction.
This is a chemical reaction where amino acids react with sugars to create compounds called melanoidins.
Increasing the surface area of the food in contact with the hot pan increases the rate of the Maillard reaction. This gives brown food its distinctive flavour.
For the reaction to take place, it needs heat, which is provided by the oven and the oil. Leading chefs recommend giving your potatoes a good shake after parboiling. Why?
Well, roughening up the edges increases the surface area, which makes them extra crispy in the oven.
But what if we could take it one step further, maximising the surface area to get the ultimate crispiest roast potato?
Well, that is what we're going to be testing today.
Traditionally, you would peel your potatoes and cut like this, into quarters at 90 degree angles.
The classic 90 degree angle gives four even pieces to turn into four roast potatoes.
The surface area available for that crispy texture is only 52 pi.
But here's the twist. Research from the University of Essex Culinary Centre Edge Hotel School found that if you cut your potatoes at a 30 degree angle, the surface area increases to 85.92 pi.
A whopping 65% increase.
And we're going to put that theory to the test. We're going to make roast potatoes right here in the Chemical Kitchen.
We're going to make two sets of roast potatoes. One with the traditional 90 degree cut, and the other with the new 30 degree cut, to see if we really get that 65% increase in surface area and extra crispiness.
But what if there were other shapes that could give our potatoes even more surface area?
It may go against tradition, but what if we slided our 30 degree angle cuts with a crinkle cutter to create crinkled roast potatoes? The traditional 90 degree angle cut, the innovative 30 degree angle cut, and our brand new crinkle cut 30 degree angle.
And in the oven they go. So now they're all out the oven, let's see how crispy they are.
This is a science experiment, so we need to put our three types of potatoes to the test.
So we've gathered some of our colleagues to come and try our roast potato variants. Come on, everyone.
Crispy.
Very crispy.
It seems that our overall standout winner is the crinkle cut.
My top tip for the perfect roast potato is to choose the right potato. Not all of them are perfect for it, but there are some that will give you very good results.
Chemical Kitchen is the only lab at Imperial where students can actually eat what they make, and most of the time it tastes good.
So, this festive season, we recommend that you give your roast potatoes a makeover.
Why not turn your kitchen into a science lab this year and make your own perfect roast potato?